Hello, this is Surid Mane. I am explaining you regarding the design of Aerator, that is basically the Cascade Aerator. Does look like this. Everyone, I think, knows about this particular type of Aerator, in which we do have the various types of steps, and from a certain height, water is allowed to fall down, and then whenever the water is allowed to fall down, then if water comes in contact with the air, and air has been absorbed in it, and next thing is unwanted gases are being taken out. So whenever the water is been falling from this end to this end, then at this end we get the water being exposed to air in a proper manner, and then this water would be we can say aerated water. So here you also can see raw water is been falling, and in this particular manner the thin film is been formed, and the treated water we are going to get here. The additional advantage of Cascade Aerator is that it is coming in contact with the steps, and whenever it is coming in contact with the step, the additional part, that is the metallic part which is been present in water in dissolved format, that is also getting precipitated over here. So that is the additional advantage of Cascade Aerator. Temperature is 25 degrees Celsius, so we cannot calculate the factors concerned to 20 degrees Celsius. So if that particular part is in 20 degrees Celsius, then we cannot, if you are considering the temperature in summer, then we cannot go for 20 the temperature in winter, because we cannot go below this 25 degrees Celsius. Okay, so the minimum temperature we are going to consider over here is 25 degrees Celsius. Apart from this, whatever temperature conditions are there, those conditions would be more than 25 degrees Celsius. That is the kind of condition we have considered here. Now, if you consider the temperature in winter, that is the temperature also goes below 25 degrees Celsius, up to 20 degrees Celsius, then if we are considering the condition, that is at 20 degrees Celsius, then it is quite possible that the temperature may raise to 25 degrees Celsius. So whenever we are designing our Cascade Aerator at 20 degrees Celsius, then even if the temperature goes to 25 degrees Celsius, then that Cascade Aerator is capable to conduct the Cascade Aeration. But if it is designed at 25 degrees Celsius, then if the temperature is going down 20 degrees Celsius, then it is whatever the conditions are there, those conditions are been designed, that that particular Cascade Aerator won't be following this particular part of 20 degrees Celsius. So that is why whenever the design we are going to consider, the minimum temperature we have to consider, and to that minimum temperature we have to design. So right now we are designing for this particular part, which is, we can say that is we can say the temperature which is 20 degrees Celsius, not this particular temperature. So whatever the different things are being given, those things we are following. Right now the temperature would be 20 degrees Celsius we are following, and whatever these conditions which are being given here, the saturated condition of oxygen, that is at 9.08 milligram per liter at 20 degrees Celsius, that we have to go for. This even this has been given, we are not going for this particular part, because we are designing the part for temperature of 20 degrees Celsius. That is very very necessary to understand, and based on this particular understanding we can go further for now the further design, the calculation for following for calculation formula would be this way. You won't be getting in any book. This would be followed for various wastewater, this one Cascade Aerators, even this you won't be getting any book. So please do follow this particular formula. The formula is H is equal to R minus 1 divided by 0.3618 AB in bracket 1 plus 0.046 into T. So the details are being given for what we mean by what, that is H is height of the Cascade Aerator, that is in terms of meters. R is deficit ratio. The deficit ratio is been considered in this particular format. There is concentration which is saturated concentration minus concentration which is initial concentration divided by the saturated concentration minus the concentration which is been required. Now next one is A is the water quality parameter we have to consider. So in this particular formula, A would be 1.1 for the drinking water. So we are going to follow the drinking water for wastewater and various you can say types of waters. This factor would be different. B is a weir geometry parameter, that is also 1.1 for steps. So weir geometry can be anything, any type of geometry would be there. Trays are there, then the sprays are there. So various types of geometries would be there, out of which we are in Cascade Aerator we are following the geometry which is of steps. For steps also B is equal to 1.1. And now T is very important. T is the water temperature, that the temperature we are going to take into consideration. The water in this case, for design purpose, we are going to take the temperature as 20 degrees Celsius. That is minimum. And H would be height through which the water is being followed. Part is calculation. Now in case of calculation, R we have to first of all calculate. R would be this particular formula. In this formula again, concentration, saturated concentration of oxygen is 9.08. Initial concentration right now, the water is available with 1 milligram per liter. And again, saturated concentration minus the concentration which is been required. Now the concentration required is about 6. So in this particular problem, the 6 is the required this one dissolved oxygen concentration. Even if it is not given, and if the problem is been asked that design a safer Cascade Aerator, in that case also you have to take this particular value more than 6 or more than 6. So R comes out to be 2.62. it is a factor. So the next part after calculation of R, we are going to calculate H, height of the Cascade Aerator. So in the Cascade Aerator height calculation is with this particular formula. Then we are going to put R is equal to 2.62 minus 1, this as per this formula, divided by the whole thing, where that is 0.362 into A we have already considered as 1.1, B also we have considered as 1.1 depending upon the geometry, into 1 plus 0.046 into now temperature 20 degrees Celsius. So as per this particular calculations, H comes out to be 2.66 meters. Okay, so total height of the Cascade Aerator comes out to be 2.66 meters. Generally 70 centimeter step is adopted. So that is why total number of steps we may get as about four steps. Okay, so if you are getting four steps, then the actual height would be 2.8 meters. We have calculated 2.66, but we are going to get 2.8 meters total height. From this total height, then the type of exposure of water. So the total height would be about 2.8 meters. So from this end to this end, whenever the water has been falling down, then under gravity again. So it has been falling under gravity. That is why T is the total time of exposure of water. So total time of exposure of water to air would be this particular formula. This is the formula, that is T is equal to square root of 2g divided by h. So based on this particular formula, we can get the total time of exposure. The total time of exposure would be 2.64 seconds. So the water is going to be exposed for about 2.64 seconds. So the time of exposure for the water is in between 2 to 4 or 5 seconds. That is enough. So if and with the we can say thinner. We can say small droplets or thin layer. If this is there, then this particular exposure is enough, and we can have the water being exposed and water being absorbed with the dissolved oxygen from 1 to 6 milligram per liter as per this particular problem. So in this manner, we can have the design of this particular Cascade Aerator.